wheat allergy, gluten intolerance, celiac disease. One and the same, right? Well, no, not really. Although people sometimes use the terms interchangeably, they are different and may require different treatments and care. I'm Shelby Cullinan, and this is a health feature. The only way to find out if you are gluten sensitive is to be tested, says Dr. David Winter, the Chief Clinical Officer, President, and Chairman of the Board of Baylor's Healthcare's Health Texas Provider Network. You must be on a diet that includes gluten, or the test results may not be valid because the gluten makes your blood produce the antibodies you're being tested for.
Gluten allergy can be detected in children and adults. In fact, some children never are diagnosed and go on into adulthood before the diagnosis is finally ascertained. So if you have bloating, cramping, changes in bowel movements, if you have trouble losing weight, that can be a sign of celiac disease from gluten allergy, and you have to be tested to find out about that. Now, if you are tested, if you have a gluten allergy, you must avoid foods with gluten in it. That's a protein that's found in wheat, rye, and barley.
A wheat allergy can cause severe, sometimes deadly symptoms that must be treated immediately with medications like adrenaline and antihistamines. People who have a wheat allergy must avoid not only gluten, but wheat in any form. Celiac disease is a relatively common autoimmune disorder, according to the National Institute of Diabetes and Digestive and Kidney Diseases. People with celiac disease cannot tolerate gluten, which can be found not only in wheat, but in other grains like rye and barley. Gluten sensitivity is very similar to celiac disease symptoms, which often improve on a gluten-free diet. Wondering what you can eat on a gluten-free diet? Dr. Winter expands on some options.
So a lot of breads are made without wheat, rye, or barley. Here's one. Some of these are pretty tasty. Some macaroni and cheese is made without wheat. Most pasta does have wheat in it, but to get one without wheat and you're perfectly fine. Here's a pasta dish with chicken. This works well for people who have gluten sensitivity. Of course, any vegetable or fruit is gluten-free. There's no wheat or barley in that. Mushrooms are fine. Kale chips work. Here's some corn chips. No wheat, barley, or rye there. Those are fine to take. A gluten-free diet is a fine diet to be on. You don't miss anything with that. You can have a good nutritional diet without that. You just limit your choices.
Remember that if you must avoid wheat, that could extend beyond food. Wheat may also be found in products like children's Play-Doh, and wheat gluten is sometimes used in medications or cosmetics like lipstick. Anyone with a wheat allergy must avoid all such products. Make sure to ask your doctor for more information.